So yesterday, Nvidia announced 4000 series. Well, today we got to spend some time with them and got some questions answered that you may want to know as well. So let's dive in right here, right now on Robeytech. So let's start with a quick recap for folks who are playing catch up. And I know that there's been so many videos about this, but I'll be honest, I just wanted to wait till I had all the information before I made a video. First and foremost, Nvidia kicked things off with showing off their newest flagship GPU, the Nvidia RTX 4090, which is built on the Ada Lovelace architecture. This new GPU has the new third generation RT cores and the fourth generation Tensor cores versus the second generation RT cores and third generation Tensor cores in the 3090 Ti and 3000 series GPUs. Now you can see based on this chart that across the board there's an increase for like shader, RT, and Tensor teraflops, and you can also see that even though the power draw appears to be the same at 450 watts because of their new 4-nanometer process on the 4090, we're supposed to be getting more performance with the same power draw, which is awesome because people thought you'd have to have like a freaking Dyson sphere to be able to power this thing. Now, some other notable highlights before jumping into the other cards is that we have the introduction of DLSS 3.0, which I'm gonna cover a bit later, and the introduction of the AV1 codec, which is the successor to HVEC and a welcome addition to the family with this new generation of cards. Now, surprisingly, and just given what we know about the GPU market and the gluttony of GPUs that Nvidia and its AIBs are trying to sell through right now, we also got the announcement of the not one, but two new RTX 4080 GPUs as well. I kind of thought they were just gonna ignore the 4080, but that's why I say I was surprised. Now we got both the RTX 4080 12 gig and the RTX 4080 16 gig. So let's pull up this handy dandy chart that Nvidia provided, and you can see that both are Ada Lovelace architecture GPUs. Both also sport third generation RT cores and fourth generation Tensor cores, as well as DLSS 3.0, and also are on the new 4-nanometer process. However, they begin to differ greatly when you look at like the power, which is 285 watts versus 320 watts. The RAM, obviously, 16 gigabytes GDDR6X versus 12 gigabytes, and obviously the compute, etc., across shader, RT, and teraflops. Now, there has been some speculation after the announcement that if the RTX 4080 12 gig was just in fact supposed to be the RTX 4070 or 4070 Ti. And when Nvidia was asked this question at this morning's briefings, the response was essentially that the 4080 12 gig is still a higher performing GPU that should be labeled with the 4080 moniker, similar to the 10 gig edition and 12 gig edition of the 3080 that was released as part of 3000 series. Now, which was true, and in fact, those were my thoughts specifically when I saw the announcement during the keynote on the 20th. One thing that I didn't know though, that did come out during the briefing this morning, was that the 4080 16 gig will be the only one of the two 4080s that will be receiving a Founders Edition version of the card. And that the 12 gig will only be available via board partners like Asus, Gigabyte, MSI, PNY, yep, they make cards too, and Zotac. Now, before we jump ahead, I wanted to jump in and show off the new Founders Edition 40 series card, which we got some additional information on given this is a super chunky GPU. So like the RTX 3090 Ti, even though the GPUs look very similar in design, Nvidia said that the card itself or the design had been completely a full redesign. And I think some of this was taken from the 3090 Ti. First, the fans are larger, which using the same flow through thermal design of the 3000 series Founders Editions, Nvidia has stated that it has improved airflow by 20%. They also have a new unibody construction, which is designed for strength and rigidity, which seems to be a given when you think about how thick and big these cards are and what they're gonna need for like support. I mean, it's like a GPU bra. They need like a metal bra for this thing. Now, looking at the photo my friend Liquid House took, who built the GeForce Garage PC, which you should definitely check out, but it was meant to debut the card, and you can see just how big this thing is when he's holding it. And also it has like on the front of it, these like subtle curves along the front that make it feel almost like it's breathing. I would be curious, and I'd love to know whether you like the new design or not. Let me know down in the comments below. And while you're down there, if you're digging this, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. For you overclock enthusiasts, they also stated that the 23-phase power array has approved efficiency for overclocking headroom, and also both the 16GB 4080 and 4090 have a new and improved memory efficiency thanks to the help from like Micron and some engineering changes that resulted in a 10-degree drop in temperatures, which should mean more power that you can ink out of it, both with RAM and then with the air cooling also there as well. So it looks like we can jump both those megahertz and those memory clock speeds and, you know, get the most out of it. And because it uses that PCIe Gen 5 power cable that is capable of up to 600 watts from a single cable, there is definitely some power to play with. Now, speaking of power, there were a ton of rumors that this was going to need like a small nuclear power plant attached to your PC, or maybe, you know, like a dedicated, at least a dedicated circuit. But regardless, it looks like surprisingly, all of that doesn't appear to be true. Now, I did ask for an official like Nvidia statement of on record on what specific wattage they required for each card, but they hadn't given me an answer at the time of this recording. But given the wattage is the same as the 3090 Ti, I expect to hear 1,000 watts, which I know some of you are gonna like start yelling and picketing about. But one of the reasons you might do that is because of what's called transient spikes, which if you look at this graph here on the 3090 Ti versus the 4090 doing the same workload, there was definitely a thing on the 3000 series. I mean, just look at some of those, how much that thing moved. Now, according to Nvidia, it shouldn't be a thing in the current generation, and they showed the new power transient management in action with these side-by-sides graph, which you can see even the current is just like super even and there's literally no discernible big spikes. So maybe we could get away with 1,000 watt PSU on an RTX 4090. Now remember, we gotta take all of this with a grain of salt until we get our hands on them, and yes, of course we are, and we do all of the testing ourselves. Oh, and it looks like we'll have like those new ATX 3.0 power supplies with the cables to support all of these new cards in October. Now I saw one announcement from like Thermaltake, but I'm not sure who and when and who else is gonna be making them. I do know we have some of them, but they're not necessarily ATX 3.0. But I unfortunately, EVGA in the news again, it will not be them. They're gonna be having them later on. Kind of bummed about that to not have them on our bench at the beginning. It's like they're missing the launch altogether. Let's talk about DLSS 3.0 real quick. Because outside of the short bits on the hardware, which was like the majority of the focus was actually spent on the 20th keynote, was about the improvement of DLSS in the form of DLSS 3.0. Now, I'm not trying to make this video 10 bajillion hours long, but I wanted to kind of hit the highlights. Now, what's new with DLSS 3.0 and what's exclusive, meaning it only works on the 4000 series, AKA the Ada Lovelace GPUs, is what's called DLSS frame generation, which in the majority of these uplift numbers you're seeing for the 4000 series is really what's responsible. DLSS is kind of made up of like three parts, with the third part being new. Now, when you enable DLSS, and I'm gonna use that term loosely because it's more than just a single toggle, but when you did turn it on your 3000 series card, you were turning on what was called DLSS super resolution, which gives you more frames and Nvidia Reflex, which drops the latency. The example they showed of DLSS 2.0 was Cyberpunk, which was initially with ray tracing on, was sitting at 23 frames per second and 161 milliseconds of latency. But with DLSS 2.0, meaning super resolution and Nvidia Reflex, it jumped up to 62 frames per second and 58 milliseconds of latency. Now those two parts will continue to work on the 3000 series card, even with DLSS 3.0, as it's implemented in new games. Now the third is the new frame generation, but it took those 62 frames and bumped it up to 101 frames, new frames added via frame generation, and dropped it to 55 milliseconds. Now, if you do not have a 4000 series card, you will not see that jump from 62 to 101. I know that seems obvious, but this is super clear. The part that is locked to the only the 4000 series is specifically that frame generation because of this new improved optical flow acceleration that has been improved in the 4000 series card with algorithm improvements, and it is now 2 to 2.5 times faster than the one in the 3000 series. That's right, the 3000 series does in fact have an optical flow acceleration, and Nvidia did say during the meeting it could bring this technology to older cards with further optimization and engineering to make it work. But as of today, no announcement whatsoever to do so. However, they have done similar work in the past, so hey, there's a chance. Now, there was some concern like what this would do with like these new added frames if you added it to like higher reflex games like Call of Duty or Apex Legends. And it even actually came up in a couple videos from some super popular TechTubers. Not me, I'm not that popular. But it seems like Nvidia was ready for that question, because during the briefing they announced that Overwatch 2 would in fact support DLSS 3.0 and even showed off gameplay using the technology. Now there was some concern that it could be like motion smoothing on a TV. So if you've never seen that, it kind of makes it look like it was recorded with like a handy cam. And I'm not saying it's the same effect, but point being, it would look weird. From what I saw in the video, I didn't see anything that like was shooting out at me as like overly awkward, but I did ask the question. I was like, if developers got feedback that if it was an issue, could they not use frame generation or allow users to just turn it off? I'm not entirely sure the actual concern is real, but you can in fact, just like many parts of the current implementation of DLSS 2.0, turn the bits off you don't want. Things like Nvidia Reflex, and now if you don't want to use those extra frames and feel like it's going to hurt your skills in Call of Duty, you can pop off frame generation as well. Phew! Okay, well that was a lot of information. I agree, but let's just talk a little bit more about what wasn't spoken about. Just like core rasterization uplift. I mean, I'm sure we saw tons of charts like this that showed how things improve with DLSS, but honestly, we don't really know what the core uplift of the cards is yet. And I have a feeling it's gonna be up to us, your trusty neighborhood tech tubers, to get you that information. Because as cool as things like shader execution reordering look, which should also result in nice uplifts when it comes to things like ray tracing, we don't really know for sure until we review them and help translate the apple-type graphs into what is real-world performance. See, which brings me to like my next part of this video, which is like the price. See, the RTX 4090 will be $1,599, the RTX 4080 16GB will be $1,199, and the RTX 4080 12GB will be $899. Which, if you look at the images here, it says it's like the 4090 is like four times the 3090 Ti, the 4080 16GB is like three times the 3080 Ti, and the RTX 4080 is three times the 3080. But remember that whole thing I talked about not getting frame jumps on Cyberpunk 2077 with your 3000 series card? Well, yeah, all of those multipliers are because of DLSS 3 and frame generation. Which means if the game doesn't support that, I'm not sure how much uplift you're going to actually see. So are they priced well? I don't know. But what we can do is look at the prices as they stand versus the cost. Because we know based on what Jensen's statements from his call with investors, which Jay's Two Cents did a great job of breaking down, that they're keeping the cost of the 3000 series cards locked at a certain price point by creating artificial scarcity via sales channel management. AKA, the prices are locked on all 3000 series cards because they haven't flooded the market with a ton of cards. So they can control the number of cards for sale and thus the price stays static. So using this, knowing that this is happening, let's look at pricing. So you have the 3080 at $699, the 4080 12GB at $899, the 3090 for $999, the 3090 Ti and 4080 16GB for $1199, sometimes maybe the 3090 might be $100 less, and the 4090 for $1599. So if I was gonna garner a guess, I think that's where you see your raw power curve. Like the 4080 is, you know, $200 or 20% more better than a 3080, and a 3090 and a 4080 12GB are about the same, and a 3090 Ti and a 4080 16GB are about the same, and then a 4090 is a bit of a leap. I think you can see kind of where I'm going with this. Last bit of news, I promise, and then I'm done. But shortly after the 4000 series announcement from Nvidia, we actually saw the release of all of the board partner designs for their cards. And understand, guys, we know as little about this as we do about them. We don't know prices. All we know is what they look like. So Asus actually did a live stream directly after Nvidia's keynote that showed their Strix and Tough card. They're very boxy. And when they showed the side-by-side comparison of like the 3090 Ti and the 4090, I mean, that card is thick. Now, we also saw new cards from MSI. We got to see what looks to be if like 30 series Aorus cards and 20 series Aorus cards had like a love child and what that would look like, because that's what the new 40 series cards kind of look like from Aorus and Gigabyte. And we also got to see like new ones from PNY. And finally, my favorite of kind of the bunch, because they're just so different, is the Zotac cards. I mean, they're weird looking, but the design is growing on me and it is so different than the other cards. Now, of course, when we build builds around them, they're gonna have a specific look to them, but you know, hey, I am gonna give some kudos to Zotac for making something that looks so different. But which one is your favorite? I'd love to know down in the comments below. Well, what do you think? How do you think I did? Did I cover everything? We got price, name, features, performance, what we don't know, and what we do know, and what was announced from partners. Yep, I think that pretty much covers everything. Now, it's time to learn what you think. So tell us your thoughts, and you know what, maybe you could win a little cash in the process. First and foremost, you need to leave a quality comment down below along with liking and subscribing to the channel. Now, when I say quality comment, it doesn't need to be positive, it just needs to be something you liked or didn't like about the video. What surprised you, etc., about the information I shared on the 4000 series, etc. Just not, I deserve to win, and can I have a free 4090 or something weird or lame? You also need to ensure we have a way to reach you via your YouTube profile, like your email. So put your email in your YouTube profile, because we will be giving away $25 to one lucky comment below that is worldwide, as long as you can accept PayPal or Venmo. If you don't have your email in your YouTube profile, we can't tell you you've won, and therefore you just can't win. So, what did you think of this video? What were you most surprised about with the 4000 series announcement? What about the price? And are you actually gonna get a 40 series card? And what do you think about that exclusivity with the frame generation? Anyway, I'd love to know all that and more down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button with that like button and ring that notification bell so you can get a notification each and every time we post a new video right here on Robeytech. Did you know we have a live stream channel for special builds and events? In fact, we're gonna be building our 4000 series PCs right there on Robeytech Live the day that they come out. So make sure that you check down in the description below and like and subscribe so you know when and when we go live and you don't miss something like an awesome build like that. Do you have questions about the GPU or any other tech-related questions? Then check out our amazing Discord server over at discord.gg/robeytech, filled with other tech and PC enthusiasts that love to share their thoughts and ideas on these very subjects. Are you looking for cheap tech? Then check out at robeytech.com or Robeytech Deals on Twitter. We have our guy Tom scouring the internet for the best deals on all things tech, from PC components to TVs. And, of course, GPUs. And finally, you can follow me and my entire team on all the other socials at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. We hope you enjoyed this video, and we look forward to more 4000 series coverage. We look forward to seeing you on the next one.